God damn. Now, if that shit don't wake me up, I don't know what the fuck will. Welcome back. That was a lot. My internet went down. Motherfucking audio stopped working. Couldn't monitor shit. Yeah, so I'm back. I'm back. Let me grab this phone so I can check out the video and make sure everything is rocking. I hear my audio now, so I know that's better. Alright. Make sure my phone is on mute. So this shit don't just start playing through my speakers. There we go. There we go. 57 seconds. Hey, man. Put this shit right here. Where am I hearing that from? My computer. Alright. Yeah, I'm sorry about that. Should I play another song? I don't know. I guess so. Maybe I should play another song. Starting from the top. Yeah, we're starting from the top. From 2016. I'm disappointed, Where am I going? Am I annoying the people who join me in need of some coins? I'm bleak and I'm cynical, weak and emotional freak. One sinner who trying to preach to you. What am I doing? I don't see the point. I'll be too honest, man. Of living in sin of you and the interview. To be dinner for two with long walks and comfortable tennis shoes and bamboo and a chance to win a cruise. Cause that's better than the cruise. And y'all gonna be in it too. What that Lipton the do. Chance. The chance and of winning is better than the actual thing. The dream that they sell you. My vision, it ain't got no ceilings. Good art is usually distilling. I guess I should be the best villain. Willing and dealing the Ellen. Willing and dealing. Willing and dealing the Ellen. Break for the sad. If I'm almost 30, they say I should stop. I ain't got that look for the pop. Unless your name is Jay, you gon' flop. Ain't no love when you reppin' that rock. Cause they in it for sport and raising they stock. Tell that to my homie Pop. Cause they in it for sport and raising they stock. Tell that to my homie Pop. I'm missing this chicken, I'm wishing I didn't. She couldn't get with it cause I'm on my mission. She left me for broken. She said I'm expensive with sexual urges and smoking offenses. I'm sick of dependence, beginning with internets and pretty checks and silliness. I think this is really it. Willing and dealing and illing. Willing and dealing. Willing and dealing and illing. Willing and dealing and illing. Willing and dealing. Willing and dealing and illing. Willing and dealing and illing. Willing and dealing. Willing and dealing and illing. That I never sent. I'm better at keeping it in. Especially if it's not my business. Why you think that you are my friend? Cause I'm trying to bring scripture to men. And I get suspicious and pessimistic cause of sexy women. I'm getting distracted. I think I'm just average. Terrible habits. God, Mama. I need Jesus to carry me. Fighting and shooting and beating and stabbing and robbing and sex. I wonder what's next. Fighting and shooting and beating and robbing and stabbing and sex. I wonder what's next. Star Wars and New Jordans. About my music, it's just as important. Could just die if you didn't support it. The devil love y'all cause he hates y'all. And y'all making it too easy for him. The devil love y'all cause he hates y'all. And y'all making it too easy for him. Yeah, sorry about that. I didn't know that song was gonna be so fucking dark. That shit took me back. So late 2016, I was fighting with my girl a bunch. I had just started fucking bartending, and I was still shooting videos. Actually, I don't know if I had just started bartending or I was about to, but I just started shooting videos. All my niggas was making music. I was making music, but I was trying to get into the internet marketing aspect of it, and that song, Splashers, that song was literally like, I'm trying to make a splash, and I'm trying to get in this pool. But everybody is crazy. The internet is fucking crazy. Now I see my stream is frozen. So I don't know if it's my phone. Let me check this shit. Cause I'm about to have to. I don't know. All right. So it's my phone, I think. I think it's my phone. But I gotta make absolute because I can't be on here frozen for an hour. So I apologize for that. My internet has been going in and out. So, yeah. All right. So, sorry about that. I guess it was my phone. Anyway, we was that's what a mic is. Anyway, we was fighting a lot, me and my girl, and I was getting online trying to market and promote my label, and everything on the internet was just so distracting and crazy. And like, the thing was, I had spent 10 years off of social media, and then said, all right, I gotta promote and market a team, so I'm gonna get on social media and do that. And nigga, I was not ready, bro. It was so much. Even today, like, I still gotta take social media breaks, cause like I wasn't tempered in that shit. Like, there's so many motherfuckers who's like, you know, raised in it, and like, so they able to do it like consistently, regularly. I gotta take social media breaks, cause I can feel it. Like, I can feel the effect that it has on me and how it's like slowly changing my perspective, changing my outlook, changing my mood. So, that song was kind of about that, the struggle between this and that and trying to be famous but not wanting no fucking attention, you know? Anyway, so the word of the day, guys, is going to be, say it with me now, versatility. Versatility. So, get your coffees ready, get your waters, cigarettes, whatever you have. So, versatility is basically the quality or state of being adaptable or able to adapt to a new situation, right? So, everything in life is going to be like one of two things. It's either going to be familiar or it's going to be... Anybody know the answer? You back there? Unfamiliar. Yes, that's right. That's right. So the thing is, when we get unfamiliar with shit, we get uncomfortable with shit, right? So, and I'm the first person. I speak just for that. Y'all saw it happen to me earlier when the internet went down, the sound went down, and, you know, it made me uncomfortable. But I have to exercise versatility. We all have to exercise versatility. I mean, if we want our greatness to really shine through, we got to exercise versatility. You know what I mean? We got to be adaptable. We can't walk into a situation prepared for A. You know what I mean? And then when B come at us, we don't know what to do. Nah. It's literally got to be, we come into a situation prepared for A through Z. Now, some people over-prepare, right? I could be considered in that class in some cases, but in most cases, not really. I like to go with the flow as much as possible nowadays. Like, I like not to have to write everything down. I like not to have to stick to a script. But I do like to be prepared. I do like to kind of get myself mentally ready for what I think might happen, might not happen. So one of the things that I think that I do pretty well is I think that I try to plan for conditions and outcomes. Like, it might not be the one, it might be two or three, you know? So I try my best to prepare for the one, but not overly, because sometimes you prepare for that one and then the one never come, and then you like, damn, well, I got 6 hours of one training in, right? But then you end up getting there and all there is threes and fours, and you like, fuck, but I didn't spend any time on these threes or fours. So what I like to do is I like to just kind of figure out what the possibilities are of expectations, which is impossible, right? And then kind of just try to prepare for the whole gambit. if I can. Just get an overview of it. Like, for instance, with certain books, like you could go into a big book, right? 800 pages. You can go into that book and you can read very specifically and detailed every word from pages 600 to 660, right? So that's like 60 pages of an 800 page book. So that's damn near 10%, right? It's like 9, 8, 7%. Or instead of doing that, you could take that whole book and you could read 60 pages randomly. So 60 or a page from 1 through 5, then another page from, you know, I'm not doing the math right. One page from 1 through 10. Read another page from 10 through 20. Read another page from 30 through 40. And then by the time you've read 60 pages, that's about 600 pages into the book, and you've gotten a bigger picture overview, not just a micro fucking zoom in on one aspect, one piece of it. Because if you zoom in too deep on that one chapter, you might not get the chance to see anything other than just that one chapter. You know what I mean? So versatility is important. It's important to not just be prepared for A. It's important to try your best to be slightly prepared for A through Z. Because oftentimes, you might end up not even needing none of that shit. So a lot of the times when you over-prepare for something and then don't end up facing those conditions, it's even more debilitating because now you have all this extra information that you're trying to draw on that's just kind of irrelevant. You know what I mean? It's weird. It's really weird. So, yeah, versatility. Let me give you an example of somebody not being versatile right now. James Harden. Yeah, y'all knew it was coming. I'm fucking Philly fanatic number one out here. Basically, the way it is I woke up to a tweet yesterday from the homie with a quote from James Harden saying, Daryl Morey is a liar. I will never work on any other organization where Daryl Morey works at. Okay. I read it. I was like, more reporting. We going in so many different directions. I don't know what to expect. Oh, sorry. I got the Zippo today. I'm going to switch it up, though. I shouldn't do that. I'm sitting here trying to flex. That shit's terrible for the stream. That's a little better. Anyway, so I read the statement, I read the quote, and I was like, damn, that's what's up. More back and forth reporting. This shit is confusing. What the fuck? And then, after I read it, I scrolled up. I don't know why I scrolled up. It was just random. I think I scrolled up to see where it was being reported from because I wanted it to be verified. And it was a video. It was a video of this man standing on some basketball court in China. I assume it was China. I'm not trying to be weird. I assume it was China because he be in China a lot. He fuck with China. But yeah, he's standing on a basketball court in China talking about Daryl Morey. Clearly. With his own face on it, co-signing it. And then he repeated it. Nigga said it twice. So I was like, damn, this nigga's serious. Because it was funny, it was ironic. The report before that I read was that the Sixers are prepared to make an uncomfortable situation in training camp for James Harden. So it's funny, because I think that nigga read the same report and was like, oh yeah, I'll make it uncomfortable for you right now. And I respect it. I like that. So, like, I've been hearing a lot of people talk in different directions, different ways. James, you're not a max player. The 76ers organization is whatever. I'm going to just go ahead and get my thoughts on the whole thing. One, James, I am not mad at you. You got to get your money. It's your job to take care of yourself. It's your agent's job to take care of your bag as well. And it's your accountant's job to take care of your bag as well. But it's your job to secure that bitch. It's your job to go out and do the work and make the connections, shake the hands, and sign the papers that get all that shit coming to you. So at the end of the day, I ain't blaming you for some shit that, you know, you got to do in the pursuit of professional, I don't know the word I'm looking for. But in the pursuit of making sure that your money is right, making sure your legacy, your family, and all of that shit is taken care of. which some people could look at as selfish, you know, or some people could look at as, you know, I guess, like, not being a team player. Nah, that's the ultimate team player. The ultimate team player takes care of the people around him that depend on him. So I'm going to say I agree with James 100% for being adamant about getting the money that he expects and feeling some type of way that he didn't get the money that he feels was promised to him. Now, a promise, I don't know. I don't know what was said. I don't know how these niggas shake hands and make deals or whatever. So I'm not going to assume that he was lied to, and I'm not going to assume that he wasn't lied to. I'm just not going to assume shit. I'm going to take him at his word, and I'm going to say, well, no, I'm going to take pieces of his words, but I'm going to take the facts that I know. And the facts that I know is last year he gave up $14 million. Like, he was supposed to have a $50 million deal. He ended up taking it down to, like, 35.4 so that we could sign Daniel House and P.J. Tucker. That right there, that's cool. Niggas called him hero. They was like, yo, he's all in. We got a real star. We didn't get Brooklyn James. We got Houston James. Niggas was happy. Me? I was like, I don't know if you should be giving money back to billionaires. I mean, can they not afford it? Is it a cap thing? Because if it's a cap thing, then why you got to come up with it? Like, I don't know. It don't make no sense. So to me, I'm just never down with giving money back to billionaires. That's always been my thought. Always. Because at the end of the day, like, a lot of us as regular people, you know what I'm saying? I'm a regular person, bro. I make about $100,000 less a year. You know what I'm saying? I make less than $100,000 a year. So we look at niggas like James, who's made over $200-300 million in their career, and be like, oh, well, he can afford it. Fuck, what are he gonna do all that money anyway? Nah, y'all niggas don't get it, bro. First off, generation of wealth. He's the first rich motherfucker in his family. Like, rich. So that means that there's so many niggas in his generation that he's funding their businesses. He's getting them training. He's helping them out of their problems and their situation. People his own age, right? He's cleaning up their spilt milk. You know what I'm saying? He's the nigga that they come to when they got issues. He's the nigga they come through when they got plans, right? Niggas don't think just because he don't got kids don't mean he don't got motherfuckers to take care of. So, I get that. Also, on the other side of it, the nigga is the first nigga in his family that has that money. So that means that there's another generation coming up that's always going to look to him, you know? The 17-year-olds, the 20-year-olds in his family. And then on down to the 5, the 6, 7, 8-year-olds who still get to see him on TV, right? On down to their kids. So, like, this dude is building a legacy and an empire within his own bloodline, right? And that's what a lot of other people have been given the opportunity to do. That's what a lot of other motherfuckers have been doing for generations, right? And this is his opportunity to do it for his generation. And I respect that. I believe in that. I admire that. So that gentleman is working to do that. Meanwhile, you got these billionaires, right? These billionaires. So these billionaires, they don't go in singularly and go, I want to buy a team. No. They go talk to all the other billionaire homies and be like, hey, look, I know I got it, but I ain't trying to spend it. And that's how you stay a billionaire. And so they all gather up and then they going on a team. You know what I mean? Easy money. And then when they going on the team, because they're business minded, they cut corners. They try their best not to spend extra money because it's a business. It's a business venture. You got to keep overhead low and keep profits high. So with that said, if they could get motherfuckers, because honestly, the basketball players are the product. If they could get the product to take less, then they make more. Real simple. So to me, I can never think of any good reason for the product to take less because these are billionaires. These niggas can find it from somewhere. Like a group of 8 to 10 billionaires are together going in on this venture. They can find it. Between them all, they could all put up 1.4 and been way less impacted than a nigga like James putting up 14 out of his own pocket. It's not worth it. Never makes sense to me. I mean, that's what's going on with Aaron Rodgers. I'm going to get to that, though. But anyway, so as a Sixers fan, I think all of this is fucked. It's bullshit. We had Jimmy Butler. That shit ended bad. We had Ben. That shit ended bad. Played out for over a year. And now we got this shit, which is ending badly. And is making a terrible offseason for the third to fifth year in a row. We fired the coach. So we already got a new scheme that we're working under. So there's the continuity right there. We also don't have nearly a roster. Like, we don't have a full fucking roster. Only niggas I know that we got DeAnthony Melton for this year. We got Montrez, who's out for a year. We got Paul Reed, who I don't know if he's going to play the 4 or 5 this year under Nick Nurse's system. And we got Joel, and we got Toby, and we got Maxey. That's the team. That's the whole team. That's the team. Yeah, so I'm not angry at James because he got to do what he got to do and he got to take care of himself. And at the end of the day, this shit is all entertainment for me. This is all entertainment for all of us. But this is his life, right? This is his life. This is his career. This is his legacy. So I'm not mad at James. Now, if Daryl Morey promised him something and didn't deliver on it, then I guess you could say I would be mad at Morey, but at the end of the day, Morey's doing what he got to do for his career. Now, he might have told the nigga, all right, I'm going to do this for you. And then at the end of the playoffs, niggas told him, hey, yo, you can't do that for him because he ain't come through, whatever the case may be. And then he got to sit down with the band as a friend and say, hey, yo, my hands are fucking tied. And then James got to go, $14 million? Plus the max you told me you was going to give me? Your hands is tied over that? I gave you 14 last year. You know what I'm saying? So I can understand how James would be just completely fucking livid. He's indignant for a good reason. But this all translates badly to winning basketball. This all translates badly to a good team on the floor. This all translates badly to a fucking championship run. None of that is what I'm thinking about when reading any of this information. So I like it. It's fun. It's drama. It's off season. Anyway, so yeah, James is basically, I was looking at Aaron Rodgers because he's doing that shit. He gave up $35 million this year. I don't know if he made more than James over their career. I'm not sure what that is, like, as far as, you know, the grand scheme of things and his big picture. Now, generational wealth means different things to different people. I'm going to be honest with you. I'm a black man, and I come from a poor black family. I don't know where James comes from, but I'm speaking for myself from experience. If I was to make $1 million, I would immediately be catapulted to the top of what my family has ever earned. Aaron Rodgers, I'm not sure what kind of family he come from. So if he makes $1 million, I'm not sure if that actually changes everybody in his family's life. You know what I mean? I'm not sure if he's the only person in his family that actually seen it. I'm not sure. I really don't know. There could be generations before him. There could be people in his generation. Now with James, I have assumed, I could be wrong, but I have assumed that he don't got too many other motherfuckers in his family in the league and pulling in $100 million. Now, if Aaron Rodgers don't got nobody else in his family pulling in $100 million, that to me, it's not exactly the same. And it's things that I want to say that I'm not saying. So I'm going to just go ahead and say it. Black people are more often in poverty in this country. So I assume that there's probably one or two people in James' family that's in poverty that ain't in poverty in Aaron Rodgers' family, hypothetically, right? Just based on the numbers. That's my assumption. Right? I apologize for the conjecture, but that's where we at right now. So yeah, I think that it's a little bit more on the shoulders of a nigga like James when it comes to taking care of so many people. I just think that. I could be wrong. I just fucking think that. But yeah, there's the niggas is both former MVPs. Niggas is both past their prime. Niggas is definitely Hall of Famers. Niggas had very many playoff failures to the point where motherfuckers even questioning
who they ever been, whether they ever had that shit in them. They both left their home franchise after like a decade. Look at me, I got a pencil. I've been writing. Yeah, there's a lot of fucking similarities. There's a lot of similarities. So, yeah. Other than that, Philly sports, I don't know. Motherfucking, I think I seen somebody put a post up on Twitter earlier that said list franchises in the order of importance or whatever. Like, which one's the best, which one's the worst? So, Eagles, definitely the best. Eagles just saw a Super Bowl within the last 2 years. We just signed a franchise QB who is in the MVP running. We got the best O-line in the game. We got Howie, which is a fucking absolute asset at this point. 2 years ago, could I say that? I'm not sure. But now, yes. Yeah, good franchise. And they actually won one within the last 7 years. Now, the Phillies. Phillies, they just went to World Series last year. We got 4 to 5, like, max players, which is crazy. We got good pitching, and we got great team chemistry. We got great team chemistry. And we got Dave Dombrowski, who is a winner and also a Hall of Famer, baseball guy. So them niggas, even though they haven't won a championship since 2008, that's the only reason that they would be behind the Eagles, because they haven't won a championship since 2008, and they had a nice long drought, nice long playoff drought. But they out of that right now. They out of that right now. And then I will put the Union. Yeah, the Union. Union, they lost to, I think it was LAFC, the same year that we went to the World Series, same year that we went to the Super Bowl. So they was touching it. They felt it. They synced it. I don't know shit about soccer, and I don't really like watching it. But when my teams is winning, I'm a fucking fan. When my teams is losing, still a fucking fan. So, Union definitely takes it from the Sixers. Then you got the Sixers. The Sixers, man, they've been playing this process shit. Oh, yeah, by the way, Joel Embiid took Philadelphia off of his Twitter, and he took processing off of his Twitter. That shit's been on his Twitter for years now. He took it off. Big deal or nah? Yeah, I think it's a fucking deal. I don't know if it's the biggest deal, but I think it's a deal. It's an absolute deal. This boy, he been pissing me off for weeks and shit now. Like, he been doing that. He did the interview with Maverick Carter talking about, I don't care where I win. He did the interview after the game that said, me and James need help. He's just been, I don't know, man. He's been rubbing me the wrong way. I'm not liking it. I'm not loving it. Like I said, Bryce said, I want to die in a Phillies jersey. Meanwhile, you got Embiid gone. I just want to win. It doesn't matter where. So, yeah, that's been bothersome to me. So I think as this offseason continues to play out, I'm getting less and less invested. I said a couple of weeks ago, before all of this shit went down, it was actually a couple of months ago, before all of this shit went down, I said, yo, if Embiid loses another star, he's going to want to leave. Shit's going to start, like, looking weird to him. He's going to start looking at the organization like, yo, we hold most of his career, which could be true. Actually, if you think about it, could be true. And he could be justified in feeling that way. But if that's the case, I gotta reiterate that I'm a fan of the jersey, not the player in it. If he go to another team, my shit don't change. You know what I mean? So, God bless him. This is still just entertainment to me, but it's my entertainment. So, yeah, I'm gonna stick with my Sixers no matter what. So, yeah, we look like a pretty bad organization. And then lastly, go with the Flyers. I think the year that I decided to start watching Flyers games, we won like 13 games that season. And it's a lot of games in a hockey season. It's about as many as basketball. So, yeah, we were fucking trash. And I was like tuning in. We were trash. I learned a lot about hockey in 2020 and 2021. And we was trash. We was like the worst team to watch. So it's going to be a little while before I start talking about them more. Anyway, that's I think that's it for the Philly sports thing. Actually, one more thing. Messi's coming to Philly. Should be crazy. Should be as crazy as Taylor Swift. Who you think more popular, Messi or Taylor Swift? I don't know. Neither one of them niggas really do it for me, but I see it. I definitely see it. When the World Cup was going on, I was definitely rooting for Messi, baby. I was. I mean, if he'd have played for a different team, I'd have rooted for a different team. Let's just say that. If he would have been on Mexico, I'd have rooted for Mexico. I'm just saying. I'm just being honest. Because that motherfucker he's a beast. He's the GOAT. Give him the ball. I'm about to say put the ball in his hands. I don't know. If you give him the ball, he makes shit happen, bro. He makes shit happen. And it'll be looking simple. He make it look simple. And I know it ain't simple because I played soccer. That shit ain't easy. None of it is easy. None of it's simple. Especially when you got motherfucking niggas who are across from you who've been giving it they all for years and years too. Anyway, so yeah, Messi. Messi coming to Philly, gonna fuck everything up. So yesterday, yeah, I think that's it for sports. We can move on from the sports stuff. Unless anybody got any questions. Any questions from the class? Alright, cool. We can move on. So yesterday I was playing Mortal Kombat where practice needed and the homies. First off, shout out to my guy. Told y'all he made affiliate. If y'all get a chance, go over there and follow him. He's on every Monday, and it's a nice little community getting gathered over there. It's very, very fun. Something similar to what I'm trying to start here, but we're gonna see how it play out. But yeah, man, I just want to support my dog. If y'all get a chance, go over there, support my dog. We trying to make some good things happen. Anyway, I was over there playing Mortal Kombat. And I'm going to tell y'all straight up, I don't like losing, bro. When it comes to these fighting games, my heart be like, that should be like crazy. Like, before I even start fighting, it just be like, I be in a rage and shit. So, we did a tournament. I think it was like a King of the Hill tournament. And, I lost my first John. And I was like, yeah, these niggas is playing different. They kind of nice. Like, they nice in a way where they've been playing for years, so they don't know all the buttons. They don't know the buttons, but they know how to fight. They know spacing. They know strategy. They know, I guess you could say, the general grand scheme of how the shit works, which I don't, nigga. I just practice the combos and the special moves, but the situational aspect of it and like being able to incorporate that into my style and using it when it's necessary. Nah, nigga, I'm not the best at that. I'm not the best at executing. So anyway, I lost my first John, and then that nigga who beat me, he basically beat everybody. So I ain't feel too bad. I was like, all right, so that mean I'm not the worst nigga in the room. We can still figure that out. And then another nigga came on, and he beat him, and then I ended up fighting that nigga, and he beat me, and then he beat everybody 5 times. So he had 20 victories. He had 20 victories. It was about 6 niggas in a room. He had 20 victories. So he was undefeated. And then we was like, come on, man. Like, you should just stop. So he ended up picking random players, got a couple more dubs off, and finally somebody took him off, which he pretty much let him. So, I'm not nice at Mortal Kombat. I learned that. I figured that out. Man, it was so easy to go around being delusional when playing the AI for so long, thinking like, yo, I'm gonna be killing shit. But damn, nah, nigga, I got trashed. I got trashed. But anyway, once he got off though, I was able to fight the other guys. And I was able to see that I'm not super trash, But as far as that group goes, that group of, I believe, five other gentlemen, there's two of them definitely better than me. And then there's probably two of them I can compete with. There's one of them, I think Practice is probably the closest to my level, honestly. I think me and Practice have, like, nice, hard battles. So that's going to be fun, though, because I think since the whole squad playing now, I think niggas going to want to get better. Me, I've been wanting to get that. I've been wanting to get better, and I've been putting in the work to get better. So now I see that I think everybody's going to want to get nice. And we talking about Tekken, so I'm hype as shit. I was talking to my nigga Tone on Monday. He was telling me, like, yeah, no, Tekken is really my shit. Because I was trying to get him to play Mortal Kombat with me. He was like, nah, Tekken's really my shit. I'm like, really? Tekken? Nigga, what? So you used to play with Wang and all the homies on all that when we was in school? Yeah, I play with them. For real? I ain't never give him the credit he deserved. So now I gotta go get Tekken so I can fight my homie. Like, dead ass. I'm trying to throw hands. And I'm not good. That's the best part. So I'm trying to learn. And I'm not good, and I'm trying to get better. So I'm trying to invest some time, some energy. I also did this thing yesterday. I was on Practice Needed's Discord lobby, which is funny, yo. Discord is becoming the fucking move right now. I love Discord. I go on my Discord every morning and basically do some prompting and some work with Midjourney and shit. Practice that. Practice talking to ChatGPT. And I use it to, like, contact a bunch of people and send a bunch of messages and shit. And then, and, like, I'm talking, like, productivity type shit. Like, the groups that I work with and the things that I do with for different people in various aspects. But yesterday, Practice Needed was like, yo, my nigga in here dropping jewels. So I jumped on, and I learned a lot. And to say the least, it's going to affect everything that I do with this shit in the future. In the very near future, I'm trying to not shift my focus, but I'm trying to figure out what I'm focused on and then stay focused on that shit. But one of the things I want to focus on is I want to be supportive. Like how my nigga is growing fast. My nigga Practice Needed is growing fast. I've been there for him, but I'm trying to be there for him more. Because at the end of the day, if he pop, I pop. We pop. You know, his successes are our successes. So I'm trying to be like that. And I mean, I've been like looking to be like that for years. I've been trying to be like that for years. But within recent times, I'm actually seeing, like, I can do a lot to support that man from behind the camera, like not sitting here doing this and shit. So I kind of want to do that. And I actually need to call him later on the day and make sure that he hears that come out of my mouth. So pause. So yeah, that was one of my things I got to shift focus with. Another thing I got to shift focus with is the PC gaming shit, bro. Y'all don't know. I'm on an Xbox right now, bro. I gotta get a PC. This shit dumb. I paid $70 for Diablo. Didn't have to do that. I could be a PC gamer. I know about PCs. I know how that shit works. I could save a lot of money. A lot of time, too. So, very soon, very near future, I'm converting a PC, baby. On top of that, the streaming shit, way easier with PC. Especially since I got the Xbox, like Microsoft, bang, 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 the apps. I didn't have to buy an Elgato. I didn't have to deal with none of this shit. And I learned. I didn't learn it before I made the mistakes, but once I made the mistakes, that's cool. I learned. I'm very happy to have learned. So, yeah. This shit is getting pretty cool. It's getting pretty deep now. It's getting real deep. So, besides that, today I have like three things that I specifically need to do today. And yesterday I spent a whole lot of time just playing fucking Mortal Kombat. And after playing a lot of Mortal Kombat, I went and got my ass kicked online. And that kind of changed how I felt about Mortal Kombat, you know, losing so badly after playing all day. And then this other thing was, there was this tower that closed up on me. I guess I'm doing it. That's what I'm doing. I'm doing it. I'm playing Mortal Kombat, yo. I'm sorry. I'm playing Mortal Kombat. So basically what happened was, I was about to get into it. Yesterday I spent like some coin on some tower. And on the tower, I got my ass beat a couple times. But the final battle, I had to beat like three people with just like my one timeline or whatever, or my one health bar. And I got close. I got close a couple times. But then I went to do something on my system. Like I did this thing where it closed out the game. And then I went back to the game and the game was frozen. So I was pissed off because I had spent like dead ass like 3 or 4 hours on that tower. And I was on the last level of it. And it wasn't easy to get to that level of it. And I had to pay for it. And the thing that I used to pay for it, I'm pretty sure I only got one more. So I was pissed off. I was very pissed off. I didn't get none of the fucking prizes from doing that shit. So I basically told myself, that's probably what I'm going to do today. Today, I'm probably going to get back on that tower. I want to play Generation Zero, but Conquer. For some reason, I'm just intimidated right now. Custom. I need Conquer. To, like, sit down and, like, dig in with that game.
Fight.
All right, where we at?
Custom. Conquer. Towers of Time.
Man. So the thing about this versatility, man, is like I'm shifting focus, but hopefully most people don't notice. Like that's kind of the idea behind it. There's a couple things that I want to do, but there's a right way and there's a wrong way of doing it. So I'm gonna just try my best not to be anxious, and I'm gonna just seek things out. And the proven methods. I know I'm talking in fucking French, but hopefully you understand what I'm saying. I wanna have a very the same tower? Nah, cause I ain't fight Rain before. I wanna have a more proven approach. I was with Kung Lao on this joint yesterday. So I guess I'll
nice hat.
Go back to Kung Lao again. Neither one of those really appealed to me. Man. This volume might be a little high. Shit, I ain't never smoke again. I gotta smoke again. I forgot. Let me see if I can beat her real quick. Oh, by the way, last night when I was fighting all these niggas, didn't use Kung Lao one time. Not saying that I could have beat anybody with Kung Lao, just more so saying that's one person that I didn't use. I kept him under tuck. Oh, these niggas was hitting 11 move combos and shit. 11 hit combos, bro. These niggas really knew the buttons, bro. They knew the buttons from like previous games. On top of that, they were talking about buying Mortal Kombat 1, which if that's the case, I'ma have to. I can't be fighting on 11 while everybody else got one. Block. Oh, and I ain't jumping either. I be forgetting to jump because he the only nigga that got that move. Nah, I don't jump with everybody. Bitch! Alright. No, I'm alive. I'm still alive. You know what's gonna happen today? Should I do it? Yeah, fuck it. I ain't trying to die. Hopefully today somebody's gonna hit me up and be like, yo, let's play, let's fight. I'm gonna beat your ass. These niggas got mad at me because I kept doing friendships and shit. They was like, oh, what the fuck? I'm like, bro, I'm a fancy clown. Nigga, what the fuck you expect? I got blue hair, nigga. Yeah, I gotta smoke. I'm sorry, I'm taking a smoke break. And the other thing is, I am not closing this app until this tower is completed. And as you can see, this ain't the easiest tower. Not for me, at least. So what I do need to do is, I need to incorporate going on Twitch pages, going to other people's Twitch communities and shit, and showing love and support. Cause like up until recently, let's be serious. I got about 3 or 4 channels on Twitch that I go and watch. You know, that's like not people that I personally know. And I don't, other than those 3 or 4 channels, I don't spend time on this app like that. But like, it's really nearly impossible for me to hope to learn this motherfucker when I'm not on it like that. So I'm trying to divest. I'm trying to take away from the time that I spend on YouTube and spend that shit on Twitch. And basically see what's possible, see what people are doing, see where people are hanging out. Cause I don't know any of that stuff. Like, niggas is talking about bits. I don't know what bits is, bro. You know what I'm saying? Yeah, I'm gonna get this smoke off. I'm gonna drink this water, cause I need the water. The water is fucking, the water is life. Y'all hear all that? I wonder how long I was recording the first time before the shit went down. Probably like 13 minutes. Probably spent like 20 minutes waiting for shit to go back up. Did y'all see all that? I be trying not to like. You get it. All right. Yo, if I ain't say it already, let me say it again. If I did say it already, let me say it again. And if I didn't, then let me do it. TRN podcast, the Tretch and Romeo News podcast, is the best fucking podcast out right now, bro. Them niggas on like episode 125 or some shit. They going strong. They talk about real shit, real situations. They also talk about a considerable amount of fake shit too, but they try to distinguish between the two. So if y'all get the opportunity, go check out TRN podcast on everything. Apple, Spotify, Deezer, everything. Yeah, so I've been doing this podcast thing for a fucking long time and I love it. It's actually my favorite thing to do. So I'm trying to like expand this week. I have one homie with a podcast that I never tuned in, but I tuned into his joint this week. Just like I said, I'm trying to be on Twitter or Twitch, like watching people shit. So I watched his podcast the other day and it was actually really enjoyable. They were like 5 hosts. Like, how the hell you do that? But they were good. They were organized in it. He ain't even talk for like the first 10 minutes. Then once he did start talking, he ain't shut up, which is cool. Cause he was like, he's the personality and the information. Both. Usually with podcasts, there's like a funny dynamic. Like one of them is the information, the other is the personality. Or one of them is like the organized one, the other one is the entertaining, crazy one. There's like different dynamics. It seemed like on his podcast though, his page is called Broaxiom Gaming. Broaxiom Gaming. Broaxiom _ gaming. You can find that here on Twitch. But yeah, he's the guy who knows a bunch of shit, and he's the guy who's fun. So, kind of funny. I'm sitting here looking at him like they was telling him like stop drinking. He was drinking strong beer, like, and when I say strong beer, I mean like over 8%. He was drinking strong beer, and it was like, hey man, put the beer down, man, put the beer down. And he was just like, no, I'm not. And I was dying because I'm like, yo, he's everything. He's the talent and he's the fucking information. Let him drink the beer. So I was up yesterday from fucking... I told y'all I was tired yesterday when I was on this joint. I ain't go to sleep after this. When I got off the stream... First off, I got off the stream by accident because the shit cut off. Because of my fucking internet. Shout out Xfinity. You're the best. Peacing the fuck out as soon as I get a chance. My internet got cut off. So I was like, alright, that was like 2 hours, I think it was. So it was fine. I just let it stay off. But after that, I continued to play Mortal Kombat. And then after that, I got on a Discord call for about 3 or 4 hours where I was convinced to change how I'm doing everything, start PC gaming, and a bunch of other notes that I wrote down because I took notes. And then after that, I had to go to the store and go and do things and like actually get up and be productive with my day. And then after that, my homie started streaming. I watched a little bit of Phillies baseball. I jumped on Twitter and said a bunch of really outlandish foul things to people I don't know. And then after that, niggas invited me to play Mortal Kombat. So I was up until like fucking midnight. Even though I only got like 2.5 hours of sleep after being up until 5 a.m. on Monday morning, I again stayed up all day until midnight and then woke up today at 8. Now, I ain't wake up at 8. I was supposed to wake up at 8. I snoozed. I snoozed until 9:20. So, yeah, I'm tired. To say the least, I'm tired, but I still got shit to do. I got a couple of like personal life errands and shit to run. I also still gotta go get my prescription, but it's funny, my tooth hasn't hurt since that happened. Actually, no, it hurt one time throughout the weekend. I woke up in the middle of the night and that shit was hurting a little bit, but I just gargled a little Listerine and went back to sleep. It wasn't a big deal. But right now, it's not a problem. But, you know, I need to have that shit for when it is a problem. So I should go do that. But I'm not real big on medications. So I'm kind of like fighting myself. Like, should I do it? Do I not do it? As long as I can hold out on it, that's kind of what I want to do. So even though I keep putting it on my to-do list, I'm actively just pushing it back. Because it's not my thing. Another thing I gotta do is I gotta go get some groceries. I was gonna get groceries yesterday, but at Discord call, changed the course of my day. Changed the course of my following days too. Speaking of which, I don't have the exact name, so I can't even shout it out perfectly. I'll have to pull up the Discord, which I can't do right now. But I will write it in the description of this video when it goes, you know, when it gets posted. But his name is Spaz215. Shout out to my guy. I don't have his exact shit written down. I don't have his exact shit, like, memorized. It's written down somewhere. But that dude, he's a good dude, man. Go follow him. If I talk about him again and I give y'all more information, go follow him. Real good dude. All right, so I'm like halfway through this. I'm gonna put it down now, and I'm gonna drink some water, and then I'm gonna fight. Yeah, I kept the water behind the fucking camera. I don't know why I did that. I don't even know how to touch Bug Vora. These motherfucking things. And yesterday when I did it, I was like, all this effort I put in, definitely should have used consumables. I gotta start jumping again. Keep forgetting. I got Kung Lao, man. I don't jump with other characters. I've been playing with, like, Noob, Collector and shit. This should do it. Oh, no. Nope. No! What the fuck was that? I just was kicked. Oh, Baraka. I give him. Fuck it. I give it to him. Doesn't make me happy, but I'll give it to him. Fuck. Alright, I think my volume's actually too high. That's dope. Well, it's not dope. I mean, I'm gonna have to listen to this and see if I gotta turn it down, but I see myself getting into the red, which was like damn near impossible the way I had it set up before. No. Like Raiden. Like, I never liked Raiden. Round two, fight. I don't even know where all these fucking attacks is coming from. I knew that was about to come. What the fuck you say? Oh my goodness. Fuck your aggression. Oh my god. Fuck my aggression. Grab me, Baraka. Fuck. I pressed the wrong button. God damn it. It don't matter if I'd have pressed the right button. He had enough time to fucking do something. Not playing this game. This fucking bubbles, man. I can't get shit off. Fuck. All right, I'm getting frustrated. Very rare. Dog. The fuck is this shit? How the fuck? Bro. Like, come on. What the fuck? What the fuck? No, I won, but still, fucking bubbles, man. Final round, fight. What the fuck is going on? Fuck it, he got another. Twice, but we in the same spot.
cut yourself.
Round two. This is gonna be a long day, bro. I'm probably gonna be here until like fucking 2. Come on, come on, come on, come on, come on. Thank you, God. Fuck. 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 I hate this fucking game. No, I love it. I just hate losing, man. I fucking hate losing. I fucking hate losing, man. I hate losing. I'm about to lose so much more, too. Man, I'm about to smoke like a whole fucking pack. Kung Lao.
Well, we look the same.
My no, we don't.
Combat is undefeated. Prove it.
That's a nice ass hat. I'm not undefeated. I don't know what the fuck you talking about, nigga. I just fucking defeated Raiden by the narrowest of margins after getting goddamn dominated for the longest. So I can't even really, like, confidently say, yeah, I could beat that nigga. No, not if you went down. It's fucking 17 fights and then 1-1, barely. You can't could beat that nigga. That's how Elden Ring is, man. Spent 2 weeks trying to fucking fight. Finally beat a nigga. Never fight him again. Know damn well. You ever seen him on the street? He fuck you up. You just got one off on him. That's all. Nigga, shut the fuck up. Round fucking two, noob. Fight.
Round
unblockable. Bitch.
Final round. Fight.
Ah. Wrong by. Not there. Bitch! Clearly I'm better. Bitch! I ain't finna get dominated. I don't think I ever lost to no Kung Lao, though. I ain't gonna lie. That might be my nigga, but on this game, he be weak. I ain't never... Well, I lost to my nigga Pat with a Kung Lao. But I'm not on the, not on AI. That's a nice outfit. Can I have it? I'm trying to get one combo out. Saw that one. That was nice.
Round two. Fight.
Bitch. There it is. Bitch.
One path is better. Final round. Fight.
I ain't gonna kill him. So I gotta be careful when then I can come back. Oh, I killed him. Nice. At the end, when I have to fight three people, that's when it's really gonna be a fucking thing.
Round one, fight.
Bitch. How you do it over and over? Block. About to block. Block. Oh, I didn't duck, but I definitely I did duck. I'm sorry, I didn't block, but I ducked. What? Ooh, okay. I shouldn't have did that.
Round two. Fight.
That wasn't worth it. too young to die. I'm only 28. Oh, this went to brutality. Brutality. Noob Cybot wins. That was a good fucking brutality. I never seen that one. Nigga sent this homie up at me, pause. Round one. Fight. Combo. It's my favorite. There it is.
Round two. Fight.
Bitch. Both got one. I gotta dominate. I gotta win. That's not how you do it. Bitch. Fucking, I just ran through a whole bunch of hits just to get this dumb shit off. I gotta win now. I have to. And I'm not. Because as soon as I come back, bam. Fuck. Fuck.
Embrace the shadows. Final round. Fight.
Did they take him out of it? And I jumped. The fucking... whatever, man. Fuck it. I'm getting fucking trashed right now, bro. Fuck. I make one mistake, bro. I'm not pressing shit no more. I make one fucking mistake and I got half my fucking life gone, bro. How the fuck did he stop?
Whatever, bro.
What fucking ever?
Whatever.
Whatever. These games. We play these games because they're fun. Because they're fun. I ain't look at this tower, but for my sake, I really hope this shit is on very hard right now, because these niggas is mistreating me, and I don't like it. I don't like it at all.
Baby.
What just happened? I don't know what just happened. I don't know what's happening. I don't know what's going on, bro.
Round 2, fight!
cats knocking over my water. So I'm losing. Well, I was losing anyway. I'm not even looking now. What a day. What a start.
Round one, fight.
How did that not block, bro? It's just me and you now, big boy. For at least 15 seconds. How did that not block? Than before. Come on, bitch. God damn.
Round two. Fight.
Really? What was that, like 7 hits? Jump. Grab. Just gonna kill him. Oh, sorry, man.
Finish it.
He actually cut his ass the fuck up, because that made me mad. Down, forward, down. Bitch, are you serious? Nice. Nice. Alright, we almost up there. Shit, we might get this done before 1 o'clock. I ain't doing that bad.
Didn't Shao Kahn kill
you? I ain't doing that bad at all, baby.
Didn't Kotal Kahn kill you? Round one, fight.
Let me make sure I'm not missing out on nothing. Because I feel like I'm missing out on something. I don't do no AB. Or YXB. Yeah, I do all that shit. Back AYX, yeah, I do all that shit. I don't do no AB though. I do. Forward XA. Forward XY. I don't do that shit either. Wait. 4XI. I don't do that. Oh, yeah, I do that. I got a fucking tiara on, my nigga. I mean, you already kind of got like a little dress on. But y'all niggas homies. Gonna take it like this. The grab.
Final round. Fight.
That's not the one. Nigga, nah, fuck that. Get off me. Duck. Come on. That's cool. No. No. What the fuck was that? Shit and then threw some shit. Grabs, man. Bitch.
Don't cut yourself. Round two. Fight.
Bitch. Damn it. I got the shit beat out of me. I knew this was gonna be annoying. Bruh. Bro, this is gonna be fucking. This is gonna be the one where I